When you're dealing with off-grid electrical systems, you have to know some basic math in order to design them properly or even to operate them. Learning how to convert back and forth from amps, volts, amp hours, and more is exactly what we're going to cover here in episode number 3 of this electrical terminology playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Before we get started, I put some important information about this academy, some additional resources, and some prerequisite information related to this video down in the pinned comments below. So be sure to scroll down and check it out. Let's get started. What is Watt's Law? Watt's Law defines the relationship between watts, volts, and amps, and says that the power in a circuit is a product of the voltage and the current. And the formula of Watt's Law is what helps us determine these relationships when a variable is unknown. Watt's Law is a derivative of Ohm's Law, and for those of you watching this video who are already experts in this stuff who say that Watt's Law doesn't exist, here are my sources cited. For the rest of you, welcome back to algebra. How do you find watts given amps and volts? So if you have a device that tells you how many amps it draws and the voltage at which it operates, you can determine the watts of the device by multiplying the amps by the volts. For example, the power supply of this little ring camera here, it lists the power on it at 5 volts and 2 amps. So by multiplying 5 volts by 2 amps, we can see that this power supply can put out a max of 10 watts, which means that it will also pull about 10 watts from its source, not counting for any kind of efficiency losses that aren't listed. How do you find amps from watts and volts? Let's say that you have a 3,000 watt inverter powered from a 12 volt battery bank and want to know how many amps you can anticipate flowing through the wire from the battery to the inverter to size that wire. For that, you would take 3,000 watts divided by 12 volts, which gives you 250 amps. How do you find volts given watts and amps? Now, I couldn't think of a real life example of a time when you would have both watts and amps available, but not volts. But if you stumble across something like this, it's as simple as dividing watts by amps, and that's going to give you the operating voltage of whatever it is that's being powered. And if you can think of a scenario where you would know the watts and the amps of a device, but not its volts, let me know in the comments section below. How do you convert from watt hours to amp hours and back? If you're trying to compare the capacity of two different batteries, one of which lists its capacity in amp hours and the other that lists its capacity in watt hours, you're just going to need to be able to convert one of those to the other to compare apples to apples. Now we can start with the one listed in amp hours and multiply the amp hours by the operating battery bank voltage, which will give us watt hours. Or to go the other direction, we can take the watt hours divided by the battery bank operating voltage, which will give us amp hours. This is a really good concept to understand, especially when you're trying to compare battery storage capacities between portable power units and standalone batteries. There for a while, there were a few portable power units claiming a 100 amp hour battery capacity, but that battery was only a 10 volt battery, which meant that it had 1000 watt hours by the math you just learned. Now these brands were marketing themselves as apples to apples to popular lithium battery manufacturers like Battleborne Batteries, where it was a misleading comparison because a Battleborne 12 volt battery has a resting voltage of, let's call it 13 volts for easy math, which means that there are 1300 watt hours in a Battleborne battery. So as you can see, a portable power station with a lower voltage battery claiming that it has 100 amp hours is technically correct, but comparing itself to a battery at 13 volts is pretty misleading and a difference of about 300 watt hours. So be careful out there, but more importantly, be informed. Now let's take a 10 second break before we move on. I just wanted to give you a heads up that I've made a quiz over this video that I'd love for you to take after watching. Write your score down in the comment section below so we can see how you did. Now let's keep moving. How do you find watt hours given watts and hours? If you have the wattage of a device and know how many hours you're going to be running the device, you can simply multiply the watts by the hours to get the watt hours. For example, if you had a 1200 watt air fryer and were baking a cake for 2 hours, you would take 1200 watts times 2 hours, and that would give you 2400 watt hours used. How do you find watt hours from watts and minutes? Similar to finding watt hours, there's just one extra step to go from watts and minutes to watt hours. For example, if we have a coffee maker that operates at 1200 watts, but only brews coffee for 5 minutes, we can multiply 1200 watts times 5 minutes to give us 6,000 watt minutes, and then just divide that by 60, since there are 60 minutes in an hour, to give us 100 watt hours. How do you find amp hours from amps and minutes? Similar to finding watt hours from watts and minutes, finding amp hours from amps and minutes is multiplying the amps by minutes and then dividing by 60. For example, if we have a coffee maker pulling 250 amps from a 12-volt battery bank during its brew time of 5 minutes, we can take 250 amps times 5 minutes, which gives us 1250 amp minutes, and then divide that by 60, since there are 60 minutes in an hour, which gives us 20.8 amp hours pulled from the 12-volt battery bank. Now you should have a pretty good idea of how to convert back and forth between various electrical units, and we're going to be referring to these conversions as this academy moves forward, so be sure to bookmark this video for future reference and come back to it when you need a refresher. Also, don't forget to take the quiz and let me know your score down in the comment section below. And that wraps up the electrical terminology playlist of the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. And if you've watched all three of these videos, passed the quizzes, and learned something new, great job, and it's time to move forward into the next playlist, which is going to teach you everything that you need to know about system sizing. Tap up here to watch, and I'll see you over there. You're baking that same cake for 5 days, that would be 60 hours.
5 days is not 60 hours.
Say it with confidence and no one will question you.
No, I mean, it took me a minute.